What's up? I am Michelle B, and in this video, I am going to share with you how you can read way more books in 2019. If you watched my Ultimate Self-Care Day video, I talked a little bit about how in grade 4, my teacher, Mr. Gardner, created a lifelong reader. That's me. Reading for me has always been a way to expand my imagination, grow my levels of empathy and understanding, expand my mind, learn about ways to better my life. It's always just been a really essential habit to help me to be the person that I want to be. But for the last few years as a busy adult, I've been feeling like reading has been kind of slipping away from me. This year, on the other hand, I probably read like twice to three times as many books as I've read in the past 3 combined. My reading habit has kicked right back into gear, and I no longer have that fear that reading is slipping away from me. I haven't formally kept track, but I did have a quick look at my reading history, and I'd say that this year I probably read like 30 to 40 books, and the year has not yet ended as of filming this video. So in this video, I want to talk about how I increased how much I read this year and increased the amount of books that I read, and how you can do the same in 2019 if that's one of your goals. My first tip towards reading more in the new year is to reduce the friction associated with the habit of reading in your life. So the biggest friction point that I had in my life associated with reading was getting my ass to the library. I will be the first to admit that I suck at returning physical books. The cycle that I used to follow would be get motivated, be like, yes, okay, I'm gonna start reading again, medicate a really big part of my life. I'd head on to the library, get out a bunch of books. I'd read a good few of them, and then a few weeks would go by, and then I'd get an email from my library saying, all your books are overdue. Then I would finally return my books with a feeling of guilt as I put them in the slot, and the cycle would continue. This video is brought to you by Libby, which is an app that completely removed any friction that I have around getting out books and reading books. If you've watched my channel for a while, you'll know that this is like a little dream collaboration for me. If I was stranded on a desert island and I had to have one fully functioning app, this would be the app that I would choose. Libby connects you with thousands of books stocked by your local library for free. It's linked to 30,000 libraries in 40 plus countries, so there is a good chance that your library will be connected. You can scroll through their curated lists, which I love. They switch them up all the time. Then you can get out a book. My local library also has a ton of audiobooks. I imagine yours would as well. Listen to it or read it. You can make highlights, bookmark pages. You can also see a little history of your activities. So that's actually what I did to figure out how many books I'd read. I looked through my history on Libby because that's where I primarily read my books. And then my favorite part, it'll return the book for you after your 2-week period is up, unless you renew the book. You can chuck books on hold, and you can also utilize a tags function. So organize all of your books into tags, which is a feature that I only found out about when I was planning for this video, and I'm going to utilize to its fullest. So my first tip is download Libby if you are the kind of person that can read ebooks. And even if you're not, I used to be like that as well, and I've transitioned over because of apps like this that make it so easy. My second tip is to have a list of books that you want to read or use someone else's. So whenever I want to read a new nonfiction book, I have a massive list in Things 3 that is always updated. Whenever I get book recommendations or I read a book recommendation, it gets chucked on the list. That way I have a never-ending idea of things to start reading. Or alternatively, I head on to James Clear's website because I really admire James Clear. I'll have a look at his reading list and I'll steal one of the books off there. So create your own personal list of books to read so that you never have to and ah about what book to read. And find some reading lists from people that you admire and people that you have similar tastes to. That's really important. I've really struggled with finding fantasy book recommendations before, and I actually had one of you guys comment and say, hey, have you ever thought about checking out booktubers? And I've heard of booktubers, I know of them, but never thought to go down that path. But as soon as I did, I just got out a whole ton of fantasy books and I loved them all. So definitely go down that route if you're struggling to find fiction recommendations. This is really just another way to reduce friction. One friction point is, well, what do I actually read? If you have a standard pre-made list of books that you know you want to read, it makes it a lot easier to just refer to that list rather than have to do a big investigation every single time and look at a bunch of reviews, because that takes time and effort. My next tip is to actually read the books that you want to read, not books that you think other people will think you're cool for reading. I remember making a goal a few years ago to read 100 books. Needless to say, I failed very fast. Firstly, I approached the goal wrong. I shouldn't have had a goal. I should have had a system of reading a certain number of pages every day. But secondly, the whole activity felt pointless. Primarily, I was trying to read nonfiction books, self-development focused, and there was really no why behind any of the books that I was reading. For example, I might read a book on productivity, but it's not like I was really struggling with productivity at the time, so it all just felt very pointless. read with intention. Choose books that are relevant to your current situation or books that will engage you. So if you're feeling unhappy about a situation, then read The Happiness Advantage. If you're feeling lazy and like you can't get enough done, read Deep Work. A year ago, I actually started a book club for babes, where I read a self-development book every month. And this is actually the reason that I closed it down, because reading non-fiction self-development books without intention when it's not relevant to your life is just a waste of time. On the other hand, don't always feel like you need to be reading books that make you look like a smart human. I went to Melbourne on my own earlier this year, so I got out a whole bunch of books on Libby. I ended up devouring a series of vampire smut books that were pretty problematic at some points, but I'm okay with that. I will continue to read the occasional cheesy smut book. Absolutely, make time to expand yourself and read books that are outside of your comfort zone. But don't feel like you're restricted to 1984 by George Orwell or purely Jane Austen. Just because you have this superiority complex where you feel like other people need to think that you're smart based on the books that you read. My next tip is make it hard to not read. When you've shut your phone away in a drawer, your iPad has no social media and no Netflix on it, and all your social media website blockers are on, it kind of makes it hard not to read because there's not that much else to do. Make it really annoying to do the things that waste your time, the things that you don't want to be spending your time doing. Then, like we've discussed, make it easier to do the things that you do want to do, which is reading. Remove those friction points that you know exist around that reading goal. So this is pretty much what I do. A lot of the time I try to hide my phone away. I find out of sight, out of mind works really well for me. I don't get tempted to grab my phone if it's hidden in a drawer. I do if I can visibly see it. And on my iPad, I have no social media. I've recently removed Netflix. So you're kind of left with the decision to read. Reading for me is often an afternoon activity. And when you get home from work, usually that's when your willpower is kind of depleted and the easy choice is to go on Facebook or go on Netflix. When you reduce those time wasters and make it difficult to access them, then it'll be much easier to flip over to a book on your iPad or grab a book out of your bookshelf and spend your time doing something that's a little bit more purposeful and planned. If you haven't already, make sure that you download the Libby app. It'll be linked in the description down below. If you liked this video, you might like my original video on things that have improved my life. This is, I think, where I first mentioned Libby. And since then, I've already had like a ton of messages being like, thank you so much for recommending this app. So I know you guys are gonna love it. But I also recommend a whole bunch of other things to improve your life in that video. So if you're interested in that, I'll have that on the screen and down below. I appreciate you guys so much. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and I will see you soon.